And joining us now is Sister Dede Byrne. She is Mother Superior of the Little Workers of the Sacred Hearts in Washington, D.C., and she's a general surgeon. Sister, welcome into the newscast. You've worked around the world as a medical doctor. You're familiar with a whole range of situations that medical professionals find themselves in. Have you heard of similar situations where nurses are forced to violate their beliefs?
White, I have. We've actually got a hospital here in D.C. that has expanded their, they call it reproductive rights, to the second trimester abortion, basically baby killing in the second trimester, which changes the whole situation. And a lot of the nurses and some of the doctors there, anesthesiologists, have been very disturbed by that. And there's pressure about, you know, being a part of that. I have a friend in England who's had to suffer through difficulties with her father being threatened to be euthanized. So this is going on around the world, from attacking the elderly, euthanasia, infant infanticide, with and also abortion, baby killing business, basically.
Because it feels to me like these medical professionals are under this pressure. It appears to put them in a position where they almost feel like they'll risk their jobs if they object.
They definitely will risk their jobs if they object.
And so critics say they allow healthcare workers to opt out of procedures they object to based on religious or moral grounds. And they say when that happens, there's a negative impact on patient care. How do you respond to that?
That almost could be a sign in a joke book, because I think, first of all, abortion's not health care. That's the baby killing business. And the best kind of health care worker you want is someone who loves their work and is really passionate about doing something they can for the patient. So if you have someone who's struggling with the issue, it's better health care that they not be a part of that procedure.
And so, like I said, there's so many talented medical professionals out there, mm-hmm, who do have some sort of moral or religious objection.
There's
so
many.
You're isolating, yeah, so many people.
Right.
How do you think Catholic and other pro-life healthcare workers then can ensure their conscience objections are respected?
I think we have to stick together as Catholic professionals. But first and foremost, because we are Catholic professionals, we're physicians and nurses and healthcare people for our Lord, for Jesus. So we have to remain in the state of grace. So try to receive our Lord as often as you can. My father was a thoracic surgeon. He was a daily Mass goer. Go to Mass. Just stay in the state of grace. Receive communion, confession, pray the rosary, have our Blessed Mother with us. And, you know, it's really a battle against good and evil, against, you know, Jesus Christ and the devil. So we are the warriors for our Lord, and we stick together as a band. We can make more noise. As one of my superiors used to say, two nuts in a bag make more noise than one. So we have to just stick together and stand strong, and we might end up having to do what Thomas More did. Not maybe die, but you might lose your job. But we have to, it's far better, I think, to lose a job than to lose my faith, mm-hmm, in Jesus Christ.
A lot of really good points there, yeah, especially the fact that a good reminder that we are still in a spiritual battle.
Right.
Sister Dede Byrne, Mother Superior of the Little Workers of the Sacred Hearts in Washington, D.C., thanks so much for coming on.
Thank you.